Good morning. We are extremely pleased that you are here. It is good to come together for the purpose of co-creating. Do you agree?
Yes.
You're knowing what you are wanting?
Yes.
It moves about a bit, yes? Are you enjoying the evolution of your desire?
Yes.
That's the most important question, isn't it? Because it will always expand. You understand that? Do you know that you are source energy always? And that sometimes you project a part of that eternal consciousness into a physical expression, that's you. But that all that you are as an eternal being never all comes forth into your physical body. In other words, in the same way that you plug your toaster in, but the electricity still moves through the system and part of it powers the toaster, it's a bit like that. You are eternal source energy. And part of that source is here focused in this personal physical body that you call you, you know as your personality. But you, in your physical form, are an extension of this source energy. And it's really worth contemplating that. Because that source energy part of you is a consistent rhythm or vibration. It's a frequency that, from your point of view, you would say has utterly no resistance in it. It's pure positive energy. You could describe it as liquid love. You could describe it as non-resistant consciousness. It is the furthermost expansion of all that is, and it is offering a constant, steady frequency that you cannot get away from. The frequency of that which is your source is always such a big part of the vibrational patterning of that which is you, that when you understand that it exists, and you understand by using your emotions that you can literally mold or contour the vibration of the rest of you to match that part of you, when you start working to align with the energy of this source and you get a bead on it and you consistently tune into it, then your life begins to be as you planned it to be when you came forth into this physical body. You are an extension of source energy, and you might be in vibrational alignment with that source energy, or you might not be. And the closer to alignment you are with it, the better you feel. The further from alignment you are from it, the worse you feel. Because there is a vibrational relationship between this thunderous vibration of the eternal you and the vibration that you are offering by virtue of whatever you're giving your attention to in any moment in time. We want to give you a full picture of how you fit with you. In other words, you might sort of see it that you are like a two-headed monster, and we're wanting both heads to get going in the same direction. And when all that you are lines up with all that you are, or better said, when that which you are in your physical form, as you're interacting with your children, as you're interacting with your mate, as you're driving in traffic, as you're watching the news, as you're thinking about your government, as you're thinking about economics, the thoughts that you think day by day, all day, every day, have a vibrational resonance among them that you've picked up along your physical trail. And when those thoughts resonate with the source within you, you are in the moment of alignment and you are thriving, and the emotion that you feel is your indicator of same. But if, as you are interacting with your children or with your government or with your economics or with your lover, if you are choosing a thought that is not in alignment with that which source within you knows, then you can feel the discord, and that discord is what negative emotion feels like. So the degree of the negative emotion you feel equals the degree of discord. The degree of positive emotion that you feel equals the degree of alignment. It really is that simple. So from your non-physical perspective, you said, I want to go forth and experience leading edge creation. And you knew that life here and now on planet Earth, with all of its variety and contrast, would be the perfect environment for you to project yourself and have exposure to life. And further, you knew that the exposure to that contrast would give you a constant, steady, new birthing of new ideas, because you understood the value of the contrast. You understood that when you know what you don't want, you know what you do want. But there's a part of the story that most humans have forgotten altogether. And we promised you that we would remind you about it, because this is the part of the story that once you remember it and begin to focus upon it consciously and begin to deliberately apply your understanding of it, this is when you become the deliberate creator that you've come forth to be and the fulfiller of all that you really are. You knew that you were source energy, and that you knew that you would project yourself into this form. And you knew that once you got here, that the contrast would help you know what you don't want so that you know what you do want. And you knew that in knowing what you don't want, and therefore in knowing what you do want, even if you don't put words to it, you are emitting the preference or the desire. You knew that the source energy part of you would ride that rocket of desire, because you are the furthest, most pioneer, you might say, out here on the leading edge of creation. And the source within you understands that when life tells you that you prefer something to be improved, that that improvement is a valid request. And when you ask, it is given every single time. In fact, that is so important to know that we've written a book and given it that title. Ask and it is given. The best title given to any book, anytime, anywhere. Ask and it is given, because it tells the whole story right in the title. We wanted a longer title. We wanted the title to say, so I'm source energy and I project a part of myself into the physical form on planet Earth, and I explore the contrast, and the contrast tells me to know what I don't want so I know what I do want, and rockets of desires constantly emanate from me, and when a desire emanates from me, the source that is always within me rides that rocket of desire and not only answers what is being asked or gives what is being asked, but literally becomes the vibrational equivalent of that which is being asked for. Too long, they said. But we want you to really understand that you are this eternal being who has these two potentially different vibrational aspects. There's the you that always knows your worthiness, and then there's the human you that doubts it. There's the you that knows the value of your existence, and then there's the human you that doubts it. There's the you who loves those others who surround you, and then there's the human you who finds enemies to hate. There's the you that knows your value. That's the most important distinction. And then there's the you that does not know your value. And so this gathering, we call it the art of allowing, because what it really is the art of focusing myself in my human form in such a way that I begin to achieve vibrational frequencies that allow my alignment with the source that is really me. And we want you to remember that this source that is really you isn't static and finished and perfect, and you're being here tested to catch up with it. You are the reason for the expansion of that. You out here, willing to explore the leading edge contrast, are constantly giving birth to new desires, which the source energy part of you is following and becoming. So what's happening all day, every day, as you live your life, you, the larger version of you, the eternal source energy, God force part of you, is expanding because of the life that you're living here in this physical form. Do you get that? The question is, and it really is the question that we want this gathering to ask and answer. The question is, as you are causing the greater you to expand because of your life here in this physical body, are you keeping up with you? And the better you feel, the more the answer to that is yes, and the worse you feel, the more the answer to that is no. When life causes you to ask something, the larger part of you doesn't just answer the question or answer the solution. The larger part of you literally becomes the vibrational equivalent of